Hello class, once again we are back with English language class, and I hope you all are fine and listening to your parents as well as studying also. Today children, we will be doing three topics. We will be covering three topics today. So today's video is very very important. First topic is that we will do is notice writing. Then we will do letter writing. In letter writing, there are many types of letter writing which I will be telling you, and from that we will be only doing formal letter which you must have done in your previous classes. Next, we will be covering comprehension. Comprehension, I will read you the passage and you have to understand, try to solve it. Now first, I am going to teach you what is notice writing. Now children, you have seen in our school we have a bulletin board where the notices are pinned up on the board. So what it is written, it is the instruction. It is the instruction given by the school management or the principal, right? So notice is what exactly? It is a written announcement to the people or to the children. Now it can be the announcement for some events or for some celebration. It can be the important instruction given right by the principal. Next, it can make it can make appeal for some cause. So the notice generally is what? Notice is a short piece of writing, formal in style, and contains information that has been brought to the notice of the people. Like it is bringing notice, giving information, written information. It is kept over the thing, pinned up in the board, and whoever passes by that bulletin board, they may able to read the information which has been issued by the management, yeah, by the school administration or by the principal, right? Now there is a particular format of writing notice. There is a particular notice format of writing notice which we have to keep it in mind. Let us see over here. This is suppose a page. This portion is suppose a page of your copy. Right, you have a margin. From the margin, you make a leave two lines and make a box. Right, and then in the middle of the first leaving two lines, leave two lines. How many lines? You will leave two lines and write the name of the school. In the next line, you will write notice. In the next line, what you will write? Notice. Now date is very important in the notice. So on your left hand side you will write date, then in the middle you will write the title or the topic, like whatever the notice is about. Then for which class this notice is about, you will write the, you will mention the class over here. Then you will leave two lines and write the content. Now the content should be, content yani ki matter should be very short and in a simple language, in a simple English, so that everyone can understand what it is written, right? Then leave two lines, then the person is going to put the signature. Then in a capital letter they will write the name. So in the capital letter you will write the name and the designation in what post you are, right? I have written one format of notice writing. The topic which I gave is written on the board. As principal of the school, the name of the school is Rani Jhansi Girls Secondary School, Jhansi. Issues a notice for school close on Tuesday 2nd September 2020 due to city bond. Now you are a principal and the name of the school is Rani Jhansi Girls Secondary School and the name of the place is Jhansi. Now over here the main thing is the school, the topic which I have to make, the content which I am going to write is this. Right. So the format is like this. First I will write the name of the school. Always start in the fresh page, right? Two lines you will leave. Write the name, Rani Jhansi Girls Secondary School Jhansi. Then leave one line. Notice you will write. Then again you will leave one line and you will write the date. As I told you, date is very important. Now writing the date, you will first write the date, then the month. The month always starts with a capital letter. Why? Because it is a proper noun. Then put a comma. Then 2020. Don't put full stop. Then at your right hand side, the notice is for all the students. So you will write all the students. Then leave one line and then write what is the topic or title of this thing. Notice it is school holiday. Then leave one line, you will write the content. The school will remain closed tomorrow, 2nd September, 2020, because of the general bans declared in the city by the political parties. First off, leave one line. The principal which I have taken over here is R. Basu, will sign over here. And then in a bracket you will write in the capital letter and then you will write the designation of this person, R. Basu, who is the principal, right? So this is the format how to write. I will be giving you the topic again. I should write this also and give you another example of it also for the notice writing. Do it in your copy. Now next subtopic let me do today is letter writing. What is letter writing? Letter writing is written communication. It with whom? With the people who are far off, distant places they are living. They stay very far away and you write letters. In the previous day before, these days we don't write letters. People who are very far off, to our relatives and all. Why? Because we easily communicate with the mobile. Through mobile, through email, through Facebook, we communicate. But before, we used to write letters. Now, letters are written in two forms. They are written in two types. Their letter comes under two types. And what are they? They are informal letter writing and formal letter writing. But today we are going to do informal letter writing. So informal, what do you understand by the informal letter writing? Informal letter writing are writing letters to your relatives, to uncle, auntie, grandparents and friends, brothers, sisters, cousins, father, mother, if you are staying in the hostel. So this is called informal letter. It is written, particular pattern, particular style you have to use. But the format you have to follow the what it is in the informal letter. You can use easy language. You can use the flow of the language should be very friendly. Not very official, right? It should be like you can freely express your views in the informal letter. Now we'll see how to write the format of the letter. Now children, we will see the format of writing letter, right? And that too for which type of letter? Informal letter. Informal letter means friendly letter. Now, in the informal letter, like there are two types of format. One is traditional format and other is box type format. Now for the exam, like usually the council says to write the box type format, because in the present time even the official letters and which we write to the officers or to the offices or companies and all, we follow the box type pattern. So this pattern which you see is the traditional pattern. Which pattern it is? Now there are two types. So first is traditional, traditional, traditional format, right? So first type is traditional format, which you are seeing over here. This is a traditional format. The address and the conclusion, right, ending the letter is written in the right hand side, which is now we don't follow it. This is a traditional type of pattern. In the traditional, first we write the address, then leave a space, we write the date. Whenever you write the date, you write 7 September, 2020. Or mostly we write it in this way. Now we don't write the thing like this, 7, 0, 9, 20. This is wrong. This you do in your classwork copy. But when you write letters or any official letters or notice writing, you always write the full format. Like date, September, this thing S will be written in the capital letter. Why? Because it is a proper noun. So capital letter September, put a comma, 2020. After 20, don't put full stop. Now that pattern has gone. So don't put full stop. Then leave one space. Then next is this is the layout of the pattern, informal letter, right? So salutation. Salutation means introducing to whoever you are writing. My dear Ankita, my loving papa, my loving and dearest grandfather. So you can start with that, whoever you are writing. The salutation goes like this. Then comes the body of the letter. After salutation, body of the letter. The body of the letter is what? There are 3 paragraphs in the body of the letter generally. First is the introduction, which is generally we ask, how are you, I am fine, yeah, I received, we are sorry to know about your accident, sad to know about it, like that. We start with the letter like that. Then in the content, that is the matter for the purpose we are writing, we write the content. Then is conclusion, when you are ending the letter. We don't end it abruptly. So we always say, now I am ending. After writing all the situations and all, whatever you were asking, yeah, for the whatever purpose you are asking. So after writing it, you can say, now I am ending the letter. Give my regards to your elders and love to your younger ones. Generally we write that only. Right. So that is conclusion. One more thing, in the content, it is not necessary that the paragraph should be very big. It should be one. You can, if the matter is more and you have more things to tell your Ankita, so you can divide it into two, three, four matter. But in each paragraph, the topic should be different. Right. Now next is, whenever you start the letter, you always start from the margin, right? This sign means new paragraph, start from here. Now generally we used to say, suppose this is the margin, we used to say, leave two fingers away from the margin you write. That starts with your new paragraph. Now the format has changed. Whenever you are starting the new paragraph, you start from the line, margin only, from where it is. Right. So, the new paragraph you will start, to distinguish this two paragraph, the introduction and the content, what we will do? We will leave one line. to differentiate between the content and the conclusion, what you will do? You will leave one line over here, right? The matter, whenever you are writing, children, it should be simple language, short sentence, simple language, easy to understand. Don't try to use very bombastic words. You can say words which you have heard but you don't know the exact meaning of it, right? So sweet and simple you write, your letter will sound good. Next is the conclusion. After conclusion, you will leave a space. Your sincerely is the subscription. Is the subscription of the letter. Then yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours lovingly, you end it. Then you write the name. You only write the name, the first name. You don't write your surname. It's Ryan David. Kavya Shukla. No, Kavya only. Right. Only one first name you are going to write over here. Now this is the traditional pattern which you should know it, but we don't follow it. In traditional pattern, everything, the layout of everything is in the right hand side. But in the second format is the box format. Second format is which type? It is the box format. Box type format it is called. Right? It is the box type format which the council generally, I told you, asks to follow this, the box type pattern. The box type pattern is not nothing very complicated. It is just, the only difference is that instead of writing the address, date and subscription and the sender's name in the right hand side, we will do everything in the left hand side. Right? In the box format, so the address will be what? 54 Market Lane. Then you don't put any comma or full stop. Then Lucknow. Two pin code number is very very essential. Then leave one space. Date you will write 7 September. You will write full September, not shortcut. Then comma 2020, no full stop, right? And then dear Ankita, same thing about the body of the letter will be the same thing. The subscription will shift over here, leaving one line. After one line, you will write yours sincerely, comma Ryan. That's it, right? So this is the box type pattern. All the things it is written over here, it is a box type pattern, and we will write the letter in the box type pattern, right, children? So how many type it is? Two types of it, in the informal letter, traditional and box type pattern format. But which format we are going to follow? We are going to follow the box type pattern, and the box type pattern is written in this way, right? Now children, the next subtopic which we are going to do is comprehension. Now comprehension is what? A passage is given to you where you will read it calmly. You will read it inside your without speaking in your mind and understand what it is written. Then after reading, you will see below that the question and answers are given where you have to solve it out. You have to write it in your own words. Now if you open to page number 147. Now for 147, children, it is given over here, read the passage. Now you will read the passage number one. You will read the passage calmly, not once. If you read it twice, first time you read it slowly, second time you read it fast, and the third time you read it very fast, right? So that when you look at the questions, with a fraction of second, you will be able to solve the answers, right? So if you see, if you open to page number 147, the passage is given to you. You read the passage, then the question and answer will be given over here, which you are going to read. I had read the passage and very fast, like when I was going, I read it calmly once only, very slowly, I have read it once only. And when I was reading the question and answer, I was able to understand what, I was able to find the answer where it is written. So if you see, if you now you do one thing, you read, do it on your own, but at the same time I will be also sending the PDF of it, right? Because I cannot make you do read the passage and then mark it out over here. So I'll be sending you the PDF. But try to do it on your own first and then you look into my PDF. That's it for the day. So today what we had covered? We had covered notice writing. Then we have covered letter writing, formal letter. And the third we have done comprehension, which I will be sending you the PDF and you will write, you will do it in your copy. That's it for the day. Have a good day and be a good child.